Welcome to my channel, I'm Gary Wirjawan, and today we're going to quickly talk about my EDC for 2021. Let's go! Before we continue with today's video, this is just a quick reminder for you to support my channel by liking this video, sharing this video, and subscribing to my channel down below. Thank you, and let's continue with today's video. Alright, so today I want to talk about my EDC or everyday carry, stuff that I carry every day. Most of them are in my pockets, but sometimes I also carry them inside my EDC bag or my work bag. So this is actually not really an EDC channel, although I talk about EDC frequently. This is more of a photography, music, filmmaking, guitar, home recording kind of channel. So if you are interested in those kind of things, please consider subscribing to my channel below. But the reason why I want to share my EDC today is maybe to inspire you to apply to your own EDC as well. Compared to my previous EDC video, you can check on the card above. There are a little bit of changes, alright, because of my circumstances. And now my EDC setup is almost like brand new, quote unquote. But the function is nevertheless still the same to get me through the day with all the tools that I really need, alright? So without further ado, let's go to my EDC. So let's change perspective. Alright, so these are all of the items that are currently my EDC, my everyday carry. Some of them live in my pocket and some of them I carry inside my bag, my EDC bag that is. Alright, so let's first start with the phone. And the phone of choice is my trusty Samsung Galaxy Note 10. So communication is something that is very important in these modern times, and that means you have to carry a phone at all times as a communication tool. And my phone of choice right now is the Samsung Galaxy Note 10, alright? It is my daily driver. It is performing wonderfully for my needs. I'm using it for chatting, I'm using it for phone calls, I'm using it for email, for social media, for productivity, for a little bit of gaming, entertainment, for media consumption, as well as for its camera functions. Alright, so this is actually a photography and music channel, and when it comes to photography in this channel, I'm mainly using Micro Four Thirds camera, and undoubtedly Micro Four Thirds camera is better when compared to a phone's camera like this, you know. The picture quality of a dedicated Micro Four Thirds camera will definitely surpass the quality of a phone's picture, but sometimes using a phone's camera is more than enough, you know, especially for a little bit of a candid moments, for just that kind of spontaneous kind of photography, for taking pictures of document, for the signs, for some text, you know, it's more than enough, alright, and sometimes it can take good enough picture for what I need. For some extra protection, I'm using speaking case because, you know, nowadays phones are mostly made out of glass, so if you throw it down or if it falls from you, then it'll definitely shatter and crack. So I'm using this speaking hard case as a form of protection, and also this case comes with this little kickstand so that you can put your phone down on a table or on a surface and it will stand by itself, you know. Alright, next item is my wristwatch. So we all know that time is a very important thing. Everything is connected with time. It really governs everything. And in my opinion, being able to keep time is a very important thing these days. You know, you can use your phone to tell what time it is, but I think wristwatch really adds another level of functionality when it comes to timekeeping. And right now, my wristwatch of choice is the Seiko Prospect Alpinist SPB117J. You know, I am somewhat of a watch nerd. I own other watches, including this very nice Seiko King Turtle, which comes with a sapphire crystal already, and I also upgraded the bezel with a 12-hour mod so that I can track different time zones. But right now, this is my daily driver. This Seiko Alpinist could potentially be the perfect one watch collection watch for me, because right now, I'm wearing other watches less and less. This is kind of great dressy and sporty at the same time, you know, so you can be very versatile with this watch and wear it on so many different kind of occasion. You know, I'm putting it on a rubber strap right now for maximum flexibility, functionality, and durability. You know, right now we are living in a time where a pandemic still is a thing, so being able to wash your watch on a running water on a sink with soap, you know, is something that is very important to keep the hygiene and keep the virus and bacteria away. This watch comes in 39mm diameters. It has a really great 200 meters water resistance, which is a lot more than the usual field watch, dress watch kind of water resistance, which is just about 100 meters or even sometimes only 50 or 30 meters, alright? It has built-in compass bezel that is internal, not external, and also it has a very handsome black dial, which I really love. It has sapphire crystal, anti-magnetic kind of casing, and you know, this has a new 6R35 movement from Seiko, which runs at about, you know, plus minus 5 seconds a day in my experience, and you know, it's more than good enough for my everyday needs. So once again, this is the Seiko Prospect Alpinist SPB 117J1. Moving on, the next item of choice is my wallet. Some people choose wallet because of fashion, but for me, functionality is much more important when it comes to choosing a wallet. And right now, my wallet of choice is this Bellroy Card Pocket Zip Wallet by Bellroy. Few months ago, I purchased the bigger version of a zip wallet from Bellroy called the Zip Wallet, which is a full-size wallet that can carry cash without being folded. But nowadays, because of the pandemic, I'm using cash less and less and try to use cards more. So something that is smaller is better for me right now, and this card pocket wallet is excellent for my needs. Now this wallet, being a zip wallet, is something that is not for everyone, but for me personally, the addition of having a zipper gives me an added feeling of security as it prevents the items inside from slipping out while it is in the pocket or if you take it out. Right now for my setup, I'm currently carrying about 9 to 10 cards, some folded cash, my Victorinox SD classic knife from Victorinox, as well as some slot that I can carry SD cards or even coins. So this little small zip wallet can carry a lot of items inside, which is something that is very, very nice. The build quality of this wallet is very excellent, and also I'm really enjoying the leather. It feels very soft, it feels very rugged, it feels very high quality. Overall, I'm really enjoying this Bellroy Card Pocket Zip Wallet. Next, let's talk about my fitness tracker, the Honor Band 5. As I become older, health is something that is very important, and this fitness tracker really helps me to keep track of the things that are important to my health. This is the Huawei Honor Band 5. This is not really some kind of advanced fitness tracker, it's just very simple and it's not that expensive. And I use it to track my exercises, especially to track how many calories I burned, and sometimes to even track my sleep. But I don't really wear this thing when I'm going outside, simply because I prefer to wear my wristwatch only, and wearing two things on my wrist really makes it more cumbersome. Also, I don't really use this fitness tracker to keep track of the time, simply because my wristwatch does a better job in doing it. This is strictly only for exercising, for keeping tracks of the things that matter to my health. Next item on the list is my key organizer. Carrying key is always a challenge for me, but fortunately now I have this key organizer from Orbit Key that really helps me to organize my keys. This Orbit Key Organizer Active is really great. It can fit about 5 to 6 keys inside, and it is very easy to use and operate. And also it protects whatever is inside my pockets from the key due to the construction of this key organizer. I really love the leather version of the key organizer, but I chose the active version because of this silicone material that is very easy to clean and also more durable when compared to leather. Next item on my EDC list is my notebook. We all know that everything is digital right now. I keep my notes, my to-do list, my productivity needs inside my phone in the form of apps, but sometimes a traditional pen and paper is still needed. My notebook of choice is this Muji Passport Memo, and I use it to jot down ideas, to write down things on my mind before I forget them. I usually don't carry my notebook inside my pocket simply because it's too big, but I always have it ready in my work bag, in my etc bag, or in my travel bag. By the way, if you are interested on a video of what's inside my etc work bag, let me know in the comment down below and I will surely make the video if you're all interested. Next item on the list is my EDC video camera. As an enthusiast when it comes to photography and filmmaking, a camera is a must-have everywhere I go. Now when it comes to photography, I can use my phone when I don't carry my Micro Four Thirds camera, but when it comes to video, I cannot really compromise. This is where my EDC video camera comes in. So this is the DJI Pocket 2 and this is my EDC video camera. This really gives me the image quality that I really need at a minimum level. This has a built-in gimbal which really works fantastic for taking really smooth video footage, and also it has a sort of wide angle kind of focaling which is more useful than the older DJI Osmo Pocket. Also it is very easy to use and to control. To enhance usability, flexibility and ease to control, I add this controller wheel for better gimbal movement control, as well as this do-it-all handle to attach shotgun microphone which currently is my Rode VideoMic Me, or the included wireless lavalier from DJI. Sometimes the DJI Pocket 2 lives inside my pocket, but if it's not in my pocket then it's always inside my EDC bag or my camera bag. And that wraps up my EDC video for today. Alright, so that is all for today's video. I hope that you find this video to be useful. Please don't forget to support my small channel by liking this video, sharing this video and subscribing to my channel down below. Thank you and goodbye. Bye.